Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Today, I will take you on a journey filled with adventure, action, and of course, romance, where monsters lurk and destinies are met. Follow me on a journey where your true self comes out and love is united. Follow me to El Forendo. Once upon a time, in a faraway land, there lay a maiden and a lad. Each of them lived in a lost city called El Forendo. One maiden, her name was called Jasmine. Now Jasmine was different than any of the female warrior. She was the fiercest warrior, and she was also very beautiful. A lot of girls wished they could be her, and all the men except one wished they could have her. But she didn't like the attention at all, so she usually hanged out with her pet wolf, Poco. Jasmine loved her pet Poco very much because he was sweet and kind to her. He wasn't a ferocious beast like a couple of these men she was living with. Poco was loving and patient and kind towards her. Along with Jasmine, there was a mighty warrior leader, and his name was James. Now James was an irresistible, handsome man. He had a smile that every woman can just fall into. But James did have a problem. James was a ladies' man. Because of his loneliness, he filled his heart with just women. He felt as if women were just all he needed in life, and he had this void in him, and he just felt that women were the only things that gave him a sense of happiness. He didn't believe that there was one woman out there in the world that was just good for him. He didn't believe that there was a woman that was good, so he just hung out with bad women. Although he was a ladies' man, he had a soft spot for children. He would often stop by the orphanage to hang out with children. He loved their curiosity, innocence, and pure of hearts. There were a couple of goofballs, but he loved them very much. One day, when Jasmine was fast asleep, she dreamt of a guy. Now this guy was the man of her dreams. This guy was her soulmate. This guy was Brian. She couldn't clearly see his face, but she felt his character, and it was the most heartfelt, buttery, melting, sweet goodness thing she has ever felt from a man. Jasmine really, really loved this man because he was everything for her, and she had a feeling that one day they would meet. In a bright and sunny morning, there was a crash next to the seashore. All the people of the community gathered around to see what was going on. James and Jasmine offered to go to the seashore to check things out. Then they saw it, a big old submarine. They heard a bunch of children yelling, "A boy and a girl drowning! A boy and a girl, they're drowning!" Jasmine ran into the water to save the boy. The boy cries out, "Help me, help me! Somebody help me, help me!" Jasmine came to save the boy. James rushed in the water to save the girl, and it was at that moment he saw her, a vision of loveliness. He couldn't quite comprehend his mind because he knows for a fact that this girl was a girl he met before, and as he was distracted by her beauty, He got some sense into him and rushed in to save her. He carried her out of the water. Jasmine was the first to pull the guy out of the water. She performed her water trick to remove the water out of his mouth. James, on the hand, was still staring at this familiar girl till a guy told him, "James! Would you perform the water trick before this girl dies?" And so he did that, and he continued to stare. The girl coughed out water and looked at James. But before James could ask her any questions, the authorities came and said, "Seize the intruders!" Before James could touch her to get her away from them, it was too late. They got the boy and the girl. The boy and the girl went on a trial. They were very scared, and they got thrown in the dungeon. James laid on his bed thinking about the drowning girl. He couldn't get her out of his mind. Jasmine ran to James. She told him, "We have to get those two people out of the dungeon. I think I remember the guy. I think he was from my dream." And once Jasmine said those words, oh my goodness, it finally occurred to James that, wait a minute, the drowning girl, she was in my dream. He remembered his dream. He had her form. He remembered her nature, her laugh, her sweetness. He remembered everything about her. He remembered how she was towards him. She was very loving and sweet towards him. He remembered that she loved to dance, and he said that she was a goofy one, but that was one of the things that he loved about her. James told Jasmine, "Hold on, let me do my telekinesis spell to see how she's doing." James did his spell, which made him invisible, and he had wings as well. He flew to the dungeon to see his woman. He flew back to Jasmine and said, "We have to go now." Jasmine and James made their way into the dungeon, and they sneaked in. Jasmine fought a lot of people, a lot of men. Jasmine ran to go and find Brian. And when she found him, Brian said, "What took you so long?" "By the way, my name is..." And before he could tell her his name, she closed his mouth and said, "It's Brian, isn't it?" And Brian said, How did you know?" And Jasmine said, "I'll explain later. But first, let's take care of these guys." And so they did. It was Brian and Jasmine against the El Ferrando guards. And they were doing their thing, or they were kicking some booties. For James, he was very upset, and he yelled to the guards, "Where is she? Where is she? Where is Deborah? Where is she?" But he was very upset that he didn't recognize her the first time, and the guards said, "She's at the lowest section of the dungeon." And James asked him, "Why would you put her there? That's the worst section." And the girls, they didn't say anything. And James said, "They're dead." James fought his way to find Deborah. And no man was able to stop him. He finally found her, and she was all chained up. He hugged her, and he told her, "Please do not be afraid. My name is James, and with your permission, may I carry you?" She nodded her head yes, and James carried her. James carried Deborah and fought his way out of the dungeon. When both Jasmine and Brian came back from their epic fight and battle, Brian, while holding Jasmine, said, "What now? Where are we gonna go?" And James said, "I know a place." They all went to James' secret treehouse. Later on that day, as Jasmine was washing her hair, Brian saw her loveliness. He saw her beauty. She was oh so beautiful. She looked like an angel that came from heaven. She was very beautiful. Brian hesitant to ask her if she would like to eat some tomatoes with him. Jasmine gave Brian a funny look, and she laughed. And Brian said, "What? Tomatoes are a fruit." Jasmine giggled and said, "Sure." Brian gave Jasmine a flower and kissed her cheeks. Brian and Jasmine walked and talked a lot about their likes and dislikes. Brian asked Jasmine, "Do you want to play football with me?" And Jasmine said yes. Jasmine showed Brian some math skills. And Brian was very much impressed. They both walked some more and sat down on the grass and talked. They shared a couple of laughs. Jasmine did most of the laughing, and Brian listened to the sound of her laughter. Brian told Jasmine he was tired, so Jasmine offered to lay his head on her lap. Jasmine said to Brian, "Wherever you go, you'll always be Brian. And I'll always be Jasmine, and we always find each other." She kissed his forehead and watched him sleep. As for James and Deborah, James leaned over to Deborah and asked her, "You want to go for a walk?" Deborah just nodded and said yes. James and Deborah walked and talked. James did most of the talking. Deb did most of the listening. James would always look at Deborah. And he would lose his cool around her. But he never lose his cool with a girl before. This girl was different. When Deb and James sat down, James was trying to woo her with his charm, but Deborah was very confused as to what he was doing. So that really lowered his self-confidence. Deborah thanked James for saving her, and James just looked at her, stuttering, saying, It's no big deal. And Deborah said, oh, really? Because when I was locked up in the dungeon, I heard you screaming my name like a maniac. James got embarrassed and laughed. And Deborah laughed too. James loved to hear the sound of Deborah's laughter. So he made sure to keep her laughing all day long. She laughed so much that she fell asleep. James kissed her forehead. James carried Deborah to her bed and said to her, I'll never lose you again. It can't be helped, so I will protect you as well. Jasmine kept thinking of Brian. She was filled with love for him. Jasmine loved how caring and sweet and gentle he was for her. She said to herself, "Ooh, boy, I can't believe you got me hooked on you. To me, I thought all the guys here were the same. All talk but no heartfelt meaning. I thought it was just me and Poco. But then you came along and changed everything. You mean so much to me, Brian. You are the path to my heart. And I can't wait for us to take the journey of never-ending love." And I'll even introduce you to Poco, but something tells me you two have a lot in common. Jasmine smiles and continues to fill her thoughts with memories of her and Brian. James watched over Deborah as she slept, and he said to her, "You are so beautiful. It hurts to look at you. You're like the sun. A long gaze at your face could blind my eyes." James leaned in even more to kiss her. She was too much for him. He couldn't kiss her. He said to himself, "What is it about you that makes me so weak?" So he just continued to watch over her. James filled his thoughts with Deborah and him. Her beauty was one thing, but her personality was something else. It was what he loved the most. He said to himself, "Deborah, you're unlike any other woman I've met. You're so cute. Oh, you're so cute and I can't stand it. Your laugh is..." Oh my God, your laugh is like a child, which to me is one of the things I love about you. "Your pure heart deepens my soul and makes me want to be a better man. All the qualities are so precious to me and I want to protect them. I will make sure no one hurts you because you are my precious treasure. I will protect you, my sweet Deborah, till the end of time."